Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. The cell formula is nothing but a short form to represent a particular cell diagram. So we cannot draw a cell diagram always and could represent that what would be the reaction and what would be the flow of electrons from where to where. So for a better form or to make the time consuming less, what we are doing is we are making or we are representing a particular cell diagram into a cell formula. So what is that and how can we represent that? Let us see. So when we talk about a galvanic cell, in this anode and cathode, the both are being involved and we are not necessary to draw the cell diagram. So to make it very clear or to make it in a very short form, the first and the few criteria that we are going to follow is as follows that we are going to see now. The first one is the anode is written at extreme left of the cell notation or the cell formula. If we have to represent a particular anode in a particular cell formula or in a particular cell notation, then the thing that we should do is the anode should be represented at the left corner or the at the extreme left side. Later then, cathode is written at the extreme right to represent a galvanic cell. So means there are basically two electrodes that are being involved in galvanic cell. One is anode and one is cathode. So the anode should be written at extreme left while the cathode, which is the electrode, which is should be written at extreme right. So these are the first criteria or the first rule to represent a particular cell formula for a galvanic cell. Now move towards the next one. If gases or insoluble substances are present, then they are placed adjacent to the metal electrode or basically inner position to the metal electrode where we are representing it. For example, if I have taken the metal as anode like silver, so I'll write Ag, that is for silver. And if I'm getting an insoluble substance like AgCl, so what I'm going to do is I will write it inner to it, that is between anode, which is I'm taking as Ag, and the cathode might be suppose anyone like Mg. So between this I have to represent the insoluble substance or the gases which are involved in the galvanic cell. I will talk it about later by giving an example. So first of all, let us see all the rules or all the conventions and then only we could understand it much more better. The third point is, at the middle of the cell formula, the aqueous solution of ions are being placed. If the solution consists or if the overall cell consists of an aqueous solution, then the aqueous solution should be present between the anode and cathode that are being represented. So therefore, they have mentioned that at middle of the cell formula, the aqueous solution of ions are being placed or should be represented. The next one. The phase boundary is represented by a single vertical line. In this case, the phase boundary means what? Phase boundary in the sense, if you know that the anode and cathode, since they both are being metals, suppose, and we are using an aqueous solution. So aqueous solution is nothing but a state where the matter is in liquid state. So what will happen is, so there are two matters that have been basically present, that is, one is solid anode and the one which is aqueous solution. So the both are being of different state, so therefore are of different phase. So therefore we have to represent a vertical line so as to represent that there is difference in the phase. That's why we are representing by a vertical line. We will represent it by a vertical line. Now moving towards the next one. If salt bridge is being present or is being present in the galvanic cell, then it is represented by double vertical lines. If in any cell, if you find there is a presence of, if in any cell formula, if you find there is a presence of double vertical lines, then it is sure that the salt bridge is being used in the overall galvanic cell. Now let's move towards the next one. The next one is the concentration of solution and the gas in pressure is also being mentioned. We have to mention the concentration of the aqueous solution or any kind of solution that we are using, and we have to represent their concentration if it is in liquid of or it is in aqueous state, and when it is present, the gas is present, then we have to specify or we have to mention that at what pressure the gas is being present in the galvanic cell. Now moving towards the next one. A comma is used to separate the ions in the same phase. Suppose if there are two ions or two types of ions and the both are basically in aqueous solution, then we have to represent it by a comma. Let me give an example. Suppose a solution, if it contains Fe3 plus ions and even the same solution that contains Fe2 plus ions. So the both are in aqueous phase, but the difference is they both are of different valency and the both ions are different. So therefore we have to represent it by a comma. So therefore I could write it in this way, that is Fe2 plus comma Fe3 plus. So this is an example that how we are representing or how we are following the conventions in a cell formula. Now moving towards the next one. To represent a single half cell, aqueous solution of ions is mentioned first and then solid electrode is being mentioned. So there are two halves, as you know, half cells are the one which includes an electrode and only one electrode, as well as an aqueous solution or the solution in which the electrode is being dipped. So this is the half cell. So if you have to represent a half cell, then there is an electrode as well as the aqueous solution or any solution that is present in that form. So we have to represent the solution first and then only we will represent the electrode. So by knowing all this cell conventions or the conventions of to write a formula, let me give an example. So this is an example of Daniell cell. As you know, I have represented it this way, that is zinc, which is in a solid form, while ZnSO4 is an aqueous form. So therefore, since the both are of different phase, so therefore I have represented a vertical line. Simple. And the zinc is present at the extreme left. So therefore means the zinc is acting as an anode, while the copper, which is present on the extreme right, is being acting as a cathode. And since there is a double vertical line, if I can observe, then I could say that salt bridge has been used. Fine. And I have, as I said earlier also, that the zinc is of solid phase while the ZnSO4 is present in liquid phase or in aqueous solution. So therefore this single vertical line represents phase difference. Fine. And since ZnSO4 is in aqueous solution, we have to mention that at what concentration it has been present in the solution form. So it is present in 1 molar solution. So we have to specify the concentration of the aqueous solution also. So therefore they have been represented by 1 molar of ZnSO4 solution. Now moving towards the next one, when we are talking about the other half cell, in this case this is the half cell in which CuSO4 is also present in an aqueous solution. So therefore the concentration of the CuSO4 is represented or is been mentioned in this case is 1 molar. And since CuSO4, again, it is an aqueous solution just like the ZnSO4 solution, while the copper, which is a solid electrode, the both have difference in their phase. And hence, this single vertical line represents that there is a phase difference between copper, which is in solid form, and CuSO4, which is in aqueous form. So this is how we represent a cell formula for a particular galvanic cell. So now we are moving towards the example which I have written at the last, that is for representing a half cell. So for a single half cell, suppose like a hydrogen electrode that we are going to learn in future, in this case the H plus that is present in an aqueous solution, and aqueous solution which means a liquid state, and this H2 which is present in a gaseous state, since this two species are being of different phase, so therefore I have represented by a vertical line which says that there is a phase difference between these two. And now we have to also represent one molar, that is the concentration of H plus ions that is present in the solution. And since this is a gaseous of gaseous phase, so we cannot write the concentration, but yes, we could mention that what would be the pressure of this gas that has been involved in the half cell of a galvanic cell. And talking about this platinum, since H2 is the one which is present in a gaseous state, but we need electrode which should be of solid state at least. So in this case, the inner electrode, that is platinum, is being used, and again platinum is in solid form, so therefore the phase difference, that is I have represented by a vertical line. So these are the representation of a half cell. But while representing a half cell, we should know that the aqueous solution should be mentioned first, and later we have to represent, or later we have to mention that what would be the electrode. So this is how we have represented it. We have firstly indicated the aqueous solution, and later we have indicated that there is a presence of solid electrode. So this is how we represent a particular cell formula for a particular cell diagram. So that means we don't have to write, or we don't have to draw the cell diagram again and again. By representing it in a cell formula in that way, we could predict that what would be the anode, what would be the cathode, if the salt base has been used or not, is there a phase difference between the electrode and the solution, or the aqueous solution, or the gaseous solution. So this is a best idea or a best method to represent a particular cell without drawing the cell diagram. And hence, we could also evaluate what would be the cell reaction that has been involved in it. So what would be the cell reaction when it is involved in it? Let me tell you, for example, Danielson. As we have mentioned, Zn, and this is ZnSO4, I have represented in this way. I have mentioned as solid, this is of one molar. Again, I have represented it in a double vertical line. And again, CuSO4 has been used, which is again of one molar. And again, a vertical line which represents that there is a phase difference between CuSO4 and copper, which is in solid form. Since Zn is anode, so in galvanic cell, it acquires negative charge, while in while the copper, that will acquire positive charge. So the cell reaction can also be written in this by looking at the cell formula. So since Zn is at anode, so therefore at anode, as you know, oxidation takes place. So in this case, what will happen is Zn, that will be oxidized into Zn2+ and involving, or by liberating, two electrons. So this is the reaction that occurs at the anode section. This is the anode section. While talking about the cathode one, so at cathode, reduction takes place, in which the CuSO4, that could be represented as Cu2+ plus SO4 2-. So in this case, the Cu2+ will accept, or will gain, two electrons to form a solid copper. So this is how we could predict what would be the cell reaction by looking at the cell formula. So there are various advantages of the cell formula. So it was a very important concept to learn how should we represent the cell convention for a particular cell diagram or for a particular cell formula. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have got to know that how to write it in a very easy way or how to understand it in a very easy way. So share this video with your friends and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.